Hey writers, besides the fun news that I got a new haircut, what do you think? Have you guys realized that we are officially halfway through NaNoWriMo already? I don't know how it happened, but we're here. For me, it's usually around this time that I start to struggle really hard with my NaNo goals. Can you guys relate? Maybe you're starting to get really easily distracted, or you feel like you've lost your writing motivation somewhere along the way, or maybe you're way behind on your word count and discouragement is starting to rear its ugly head. Well, in this video, I wanted to share some tips that usually help me get back on track when the excitement of NaNoWriMo is starting to wane and I'm just not sure I'm going to make it. These tips are actually some quick highlights from a longer live stream I did last year. First, you'll see me list some common distractions you might be facing. Let's see how many you can identify with too. And then I share some ways that usually help revive my motivation to get writing again. I'll also share some great ideas that came from those in the live chat box during the stream. You ready to get your NaNoWriMo mojo back? Let's do this.
So what are your favorite writing distractions? Social media is totally a distraction all the time. My phone is a distraction all the time. And I think I put this somewhere in the slideshow. I can't remember, but I love setting my phone to airplane mode, and that just keeps my phone from buzzing so that I don't have a reason to go to my phone. Or if I go to like search something on my phone, I remember, oh yeah, I'm on airplane mode and I shouldn't be on my phone. Other people also mentioned the Forest app earlier. And then favorite writing distraction is my husband. Some people have pets that come up and like, you know, nuzzle them and like, you know, pay attention to me. And that's pretty much my husband. We've had to set up some boundaries and be like, babe, I'm working right now. I love you, but I need some time. I disable Facebook off my phone every night and enable it again at night right before bed. Otherwise, I mindlessly click on and get sucked in. And that's something else that I've heard people say is they just like delete an app or they disable notifications for it. Brainstorming and other stories. Yes, those can totally be distractions. Research. I should have put research on this slide because research is my nemesis and I need to stop doing it while I'm drafting. AuthorTube can be an inspiration or distraction when I'm supposed to be writing. YouTube is a huge distraction for me as well, and especially when I'm going to research something and suddenly find myself creating tons of Pinterest boards or watching pet videos on YouTube. Yes! Pet social media, certain music artists. I will focus on the song instead of the writing. That is why I listen to instrumental music usually instead of ones with words, but sometimes that's also the inspiration. And the messy room. Yes, if there is a mess, I can't focus. So having a cleaning session before NaNoWriMo hits in your writing space. Okay, now that we talked about distractions, let's talk about what are your favorite ways to get back on track. Oh, this is where I mentioned airplane mode. Sprinting with friends is definitely super motivational and helping me stay accountable. Having a why or a story core statement. So this is if you're getting not just distracted, but you're getting discouraged and you're getting stuck in your story. And for me, if I have like a statement, like a mission statement pretty much for your story of like, why are you writing the story? Why does it matter to you? Why does it need to be read by other people? Or a story core, like a pitch or the original inspiration for why you wanted to write this story or what like different elements came together. And I think sometimes we can get into this drafting mode and we're so like in the minutia that we forget why we even started writing the story in the first place. And if you have that to sort of go back to in those moments, and you've already prepped that before you start NaNoWriMo, then in those moments where you're discouraged and just lost and just not knowing where to go, you can come back to that core. Another thing is to have a list of affirmations, again, to like get you back in the zone, get you back motivated, believing in your story again, doing a vision board, doing a Pinterest board, having that to like sort of give you those visuals when you're stuck on descriptions or again, losing like that drive for the stories that can like sort of spark it again. You can create some kind of mock cover that you could put on as your phone background. So whenever you get distracted by your phone and you see that mock cover of your book, you're like, nope, I need to put my book first. You can put it on the notebook that you're brainstorming. You can print it and put it like in front of your desk. But I think having like that visual of like, this book is going to be a book someday can really motivate you too. Posting daily progress somewhere, again, having some kind of accountability can be really helpful. Again, you don't want to do that until you've hit your word count for the day so that you don't get distracted and not hit your word count. But that is something that you can do on Instagram, on Twitter. If you have a YouTube channel, you could do a weekly or daily YouTube vlogs. You could get into our Patreon group and sort of report your progress every day. We have like a weekly goals tracker thread. And then we also now have a daily one for anybody who wants that daily accountability. And then milestone rewards. That is another thing that you can sort of say, okay, like, I'm not going to get this reward. I'm not going to get this thing that I really, really want unless I meet my goal. And so that can totally help you get back on track as well. Breaking my goal into smaller pieces, definitely with rewards, can be anything from hot chocolate to a walk, taking time for self-care. Seems silly, not silly, but it increases my productivity. No, not silly at all. Self-care is super important. I want to leave something for my children when I'm gone. My books will likely be their greatest treasure. Oh my gosh. It's a lot of pressure, but I think it's a good pressure. That is a awesome story core or like why statement. Nano badges really motivate me. Awesome. You can definitely use those on the NaNoWriMo website. Be sure to add future bestselling author to that mock cover for an extra way to psych yourself up for writing. Yeah. Oh my gosh, that's a great thing to put on your mock covers. I love it. Get up and go outside. Move about a little before going back inside to continue working also helps. I love that. Writing sprints, even if I do them alone, help me get back into working and then continue to work. Also, sometimes leaving my workspace and walking a little helps me to focus again. So sort of getting like a brain break. Ambient sound music, like looking up on YouTube a cafe. Oh, with rain and jazz music. That sounds like fun. There are tons of different ones, but that always helps me get back to work on things I'm supposed to work on. I play drone footage for beautiful locations on my TV with YouTube to inspire me. That is cool. I would have never thought of that, but I like it. Find walking and thinking about what to write really helps. I have not gotten myself out there to just be walking in the midst of writing, but I'm gonna have to go do that. Walking the dog while listening to epic writing music and picturing the next scene. Ooh, I like the visualizing of the next scene. Leanne says, if I've been distracted too long, I go back and read my original brainstorming notes. It reminds me of how much fun the story is. Definitely. And that's what I meant too about like, you know, having some kind of course, some kind of why, some kind of like refresher of like when you lose your like motivation, it's just like, I can go back to this. I compile my novel with all background info dump, turn it into a PDF, listen to it on my phone with PDF reader to get a bird's eye view of where I need to go, and then can do while walking, driving, or going to bed. I love that you just allow yourself to just info dump in that first draft. And I should probably do that too, because that's one of my things that like, I'm always like, stop info dumping. But again, you're just telling yourself the story. So go ahead and do it.
The last thing I wanted to add to this list is about writing rewards, since they can be super helpful. In case you're struggling to come up with some of your own ideas, I shared a bunch in last week's video where I also shared a ton of other helpful apps, resources, and other must-haves that are perfect for NaNoWriMo. I'll link that down below, but I also wanted to know, is there something that helps you get back to writing that we didn't list in this video? Let us know in the comments so that everyone can find even more helpful info down below. Speaking of getting back on track, I'm gonna start applying some of these ideas so I can get back to writing myself. But if you're looking for even more helpful videos like these, I have a whole playlist of NaNoWriMo related videos down below, or you can check out one of these two videos and we'll see you there.